Okay, we're going to make a water distiller, and you just need a few components, a pressure cooker, okay, just a standard pressure cooker that you can find even in a thrift shop for a few dollars, okay, and as long as it has a rubber seal, you're going to be in good shape, and all the components are there for safety. But we're just going to go ahead and get started on this. Little bit of tubing. I think I got about 15 feet. It's not critical, whatever you got handy, especially in an emergency. You pick up whatever you got and use it. A couple different kinds of adapter hose so that I can adapt the copper pipe to this without damaging this or changing anything, and I can still use it as a cooker. Maybe a couple clamps. You can use anything. If you don't have these, they're usually easy to find, but you know, like a bread twisty, zip ties, you know, any kind of heavy duty steel wire or anything like that that you could use to wrap around here just to keep this sealed on here and not pop off. We're going to be messing with steam. You don't want to be getting burnt. So I'm going to clean this copper tubing up a little bit. You don't have to, because it's just the outside. Your water is all going to be on the inside of the tubing. So, but I just want to make it look a little pretty. We'll go from there. Okay, we're a little scuffed up now. Looks a little better. It's nothing fantastic. Doesn't have to be, like I said. I just wanted to clean it up a little bit. Now I'm going to wrap this around a can and coil this a little tighter, okay, to make it a little bit more compact. You can leave it like this. You can put it in a bucket or something like that, or another can, maybe a number 10 can or something, to cool it off. You'll see why in a minute, hopefully. And I'm going to coil this up just the way I like it. It doesn't matter. Not a big science. You'll see why then. Okay, I'm going to wrap this around a can just to keep it from kinking. You definitely don't want to kink in this. You'll have to cut it short if you do. So I'm going to make a coil around this can of tomatoes. And hopefully, there we go. Yeah, it's not hard. But like I said, be careful. You don't want to kink this. Definitely don't kink it. This is really soft copper and easy to work with, easy to screw up too, but it's nice and soft for bending and straightening. And now what we're gonna do is more or less try to put a straight end on it and something like that. Gonna go ahead and put some water in. For our first test, I'm not gonna put a whole lot in. I just wanna get some steam through it and get it working. So probably enough right there for my first test. Just regular tap water, anything that you wanna distill. Of course, non-alcoholic, right? Okay, all you gotta do is put the lid on. make sure it's locked in place. And then, like I said, we're going to use probably this rubber. To adapt to my copper. Okay, and we're just going to put a clamp here and a clamp here, and let that go. So hopefully you can see what I'm doing there, and nothing much to it. Okay. Well, hopefully you can see the whole thing there. It's hard to get it all in one shot. And of course you can see my belly, but this should be complete. All we want to do is keep this cool, and you can do it several ways. Put a container underneath of it and fill it with cold water, ice water, anything like that. You can put rags on it, paper or towels, and get them soaking wet. You could do both. You could do anything to keep this cooler as cold as possible. Let's put it that way. And that'll allow this to condense the steam down into a container. And we're just gonna go ahead and get a container. I'm gonna try it straight without anything. And then I'm gonna try a rag on it and try to wet it down and see what really works good. Whatever you have is what you're going to have to work with. But like I said, a tub of water of some kind would be real nice to help cool this down and allow the steam to condense. And that's what you're doing here. You're going to fire this up, get the steam coming out. It's going to come out here. It's going to have a minimal pressure on it, but it'll have a little bit on there. So that's why you want those clamps. You certainly don't want to get sprayed with hot water. So you want to be careful around it. It's going to get hot, but you could use this indoors or outdoors. You could put a wood fire under it, charcoal, do it on your grill, whatever you need to do to get this to boil water and produce a steam. All right, we're going to try it out here. Starting to steam. I'm going to have to cool that down. There's no way that's going to condense enough for me. I need to get it colder. So I'm going to put some rags on that coil. It seems to help. We're getting some amount out anyway. It's coming out. There's a lot of steam though. I think I'm going to need a water bath. I mean, if that's all I had, it's working. You know, putting the rag on there, soaking wet. They are getting hot, so I'm going to turn this down a little bit and make sure I don't build up too much pressure or nothing, which I can't, I don't think, with an open hole. Looks good, though. It's actually working. Okay, we got some ice water now, and it's not even halfway down in that bath water, but I'll bet you it helps to cool it. Steam's coming through it right now. I got it into a pot with a lid on it. Hopefully that'll contain more. Let's see how it does. Okay, it's starting to come out. See if I can zoom you in a little bit. I don't know. It's dripping. It's not hot. Well, it works pretty good there. No steam whatsoever coming out. Just cool water. Real cool water. That's pretty neat. Let's see how much we get. Should be pressurized enough to push it. I hope. We'll keep an eye on it. Make sure your line doesn't kink. The copper isn't kinked. The rubber hose adapter is not kinked. You don't want this thing to build up pressure. You got to make sure that it's open and flowing freely. If it does, it can't build up pressure. So it should be just fine. It works. It works. Eureka. Well, it's making water. Looks pretty good. The ice is melted, but it's still working. There we go. Distilled water at home.